Yes, I do. Yes, I do. It was nice to see the opinion and the perspective from the youth that came from a topical note. So we are here to give our opinion on the new model, the seniors portfolio. I have good things to say about the integrated system model. Mary just spoke. I want to also remember what Doris said about the 24-hour staff support that we need to deal with our new model to assist our vulnerable tenants. They are moving into a new model of TCH housing. I'm here just to make a comment in relation to communications. If you're going to separate TCAC and the seniors portfolio, I wonder if the meetings that are currently held at 981 Yonge Street are going to be conducted through the magic of the TV. See, we have a camera right behind us and on all the sides. Same thing we have at the Toronto Community Housing Board meetings. We have cameras, but unfortunately, we only live stream the meetings, and we don't archive the meetings for further review or understanding. So I have spoken on this matter at the, and not just myself, but several members of the community have spoken about changing the model we are communicating with tenants who are unable to attend the meetings. So I would like to appreciate if you can upgrade the live stream into the City TV, City channel, YouTube channel, so that whenever members of the community, like the youth that just came by, and they want to learn from us from previous meetings that we have deputed, they can be able to understand more and more about the corporation, which you know is a very complex one. So I also want to encourage that OCHI become an independent oversight entity away from the Toronto housing, because that will give them an opportunity to OCHI to deal with our vulnerable tenants and in an independent way and not influenced by the corporation policies or direction by upper management. So I like to encourage the OCHI is becoming independent. Kathy Milson and Kathy Birch are also requested that we have to include universal accessibility design for all the new units that are going to be dedicated for our vulnerable tenants, our seniors. So we need to spend the money that it was promised by Mr. Justin Trudeau. I think he's going to give us a $1.3 billion. So hopefully that money will help to create universal accessibility design units so we can deal with our vulnerable tenants. And lastly, I just want to let you know that 220 Oak Street is a former seniors only building. And we have many of those still around, and they're living fear, in constant fear. I have requested TCAC to install cameras in the upper floors, and in return, they told me that they're going to install only one camera per floor and not installing cameras on the stairways, which is, you know, the focus of attention of the problem that we have at 220 Oak Street. So I want to encourage Mr. Mayor to have a conversation with Mr. Kevin Marshman or Tim Murphy to address that gap, because one camera per floor is not resolving the issues that we have. Tell them time and time again, we need to have cameras, up to maybe three cameras per floor, and cameras also on the hallways and stairways. They're missing from the 27 to the second floor. And lastly, I want to encourage the tenants' first team to provide this notice, which is a standard that alerts tenants or any public attending a city meeting, that the picture will be taken until TCAC gets their act together and start to get into the YouTube channel business. I am in charge of sharing this information with tenants that are not unable to attend the meetings because, et cetera, A, B, and C reasons. So this is something that I want to encourage the tenants first to post this information at the meetings or prior to the to begin the meetings. And that's all.
Thank you.
You're up.